Impressionism was an important movement of the 19th century. The works of the Impressionists can be seen here. Manet and Monet are represented by their portraits. Impressionist movement is characterized by free, rapid brush strokes and the use of a bright, luminous color palette. The portrait to the extreme right is that of Madame Monet, Camille, who has been painted on her deathbed by the artist in rapid brush strokes. There are also other important Impressionist painters such as Renoir and Degas, whose works can be seen here. Renoir was particularly known for his portraits of women and children. The portrait in the center is that of Mary Cassatt, the American Impressionist painter. An important portrait painter was the American-born painter John Singer Sargent, who spent most of his career in Europe. Sargent's portraits are extremely popular, and Sargent's style is characterized by a technical facility as also the use of quick brushwork and capturing the light. The portrait in the center is a well-known work called Madame X. The post-impressionist had formal concerns such as solidity, three-dimensionality, structure and composition. In these three portraits painted by Paul Cézanne, Vincent van Gogh and Paul Gauguin, one can see in the first one the portrait of Madame Cézanne, which has been painted by colored tones which bring in a solid quality to the portrait. The painting, the portrait in the center, is a self-portrait by Vincent van Gogh, which has an expressive use of line and color. This portrait is also known as self-portrait with bandaged ear. The portrait to the extreme right is the self-portrait of Paul Gauguin, who is characterized by his distinctive use of rhythmic line and flat color planes. The post-impressionists influenced the 20th century art movements such as Fauvism, Cubism and Expressionism. Here are three portraits. The one to the left is by the famous Fauvist painter Henri Matisse. Matisse is known for his distinctive use of color. He used color for color's sake and explored the different expressive and decorative possibilities of color. This portrait is that of his wife, Madame Matisse, and is also known as the green stripe for the very distinct green colored stripe which goes from her forehead to the chin. The other two portraits are of the expressionists Haeckel and Paul Klee. Some other expressionist works, self-portrait of Kirschner is represented here, while the one to the right is a self-portrait of Oskar Kokoschka. There are other self-portraits painted by expressionist painters known for its use of color and line. These are by artists such as Munch, Enser and Nolde. One of the greatest artists of the 20th century was the Spanish artist Pablo Picasso. Picasso has painted several portraits in his lifetime. The portraits featured here include a self-portrait which was painted in his youth in the so-called Blue Period, when Picasso was a struggling artist in Paris. Picasso often also painted his wives and mistresses who were considered to be his muses. The portrait in the center is of Dora Maar. The portrait to the right is of his son Paul. Another expressive portrait is of Marie Therese. An unusual portrait can be seen to the right, which was painted in the analytical cubist style, which shows the art dealer Ambroise Vollard. The cubist style is characterized by the breaking up of the human figure here into colored planes. Here are two portraits of Salvador Dali, the famous Spanish painter, that of his wife Gala. They are painted in the Surrealist style. Surrealism was an important movement in the 20th century, influenced by the Freudian theory of dreams. In these two portraits, we can see Dali using a lot of elements such as decaying flesh, bones, a sparse landscape, which were very typical of his work. The work featured to the left is that of the famous Surrealist painter René Magritte. Surrealist paintings have familiar looking objects placed in unfamiliar, strange settings. In this work, which is a self-portrait, the artist can be seen looking sideways while painting a large work set up on his easel. Magritte's work is known for his technical brilliance. The portrait to the right is a self-portrait by Marc Chagall. Chagall was born in Belarus, earlier Russia, and he was of Jewish origin. His work reflects his childhood memories as well as his later years spent as an artist in Paris. One of the most important sculptors of the 19th century was the French sculptor Auguste Rodin. Rodin has made many famous works such as The Thinker and The Gates of Hell. Rodin was extremely well known for his proficient handling of clay and his large sculptures in bronze and marble are extremely famous. Here are two portrait sculptures. One to the left is of Camille Claudel, a sculptor and Rodin's lover. The one to the right is of a famous French novelist, Balzac. The Swiss sculptor Alberto Giacometti is one of the most important sculptors of the 20th century. He was influenced by movements such as Cubism and Surrealism, and his work makes a philosophical inquiry into the human condition. He was also influenced by existentialism, which is seen in his work. Giacometti's sculptures are thin and wiry and elongated. Here are two examples of his portrait sculptures. The one to the left is of his favorite model, Annette, and the one to the right is of Diego. They show the choppy strokes for which Giacometti was well known. An important portrait painter is the British artist Lucian Freud. Freud's portrait, the self-portrait, can be seen here. Freud's work is characterized by the use of a somber color palette and thick color or impasto. He successfully penetrates deep into the character of his sitter and uses unconventional poses. The painting to the right, The Artist's Parents, is a work by famous British painter David Hockney. Hockney was a major contributor to the movement called Pop Art Movement, which arose in the 1960s. Pop art was greatly influenced by popular culture and technology. This particular portrait has a certain kind of casualness as well as shows the skill in draftsmanship which Hockney possessed. The famous American pop artist Andy Warhol is known for his use of technology such as photography and serigraphy. In these three portraits, done in the technique of serigraphy or silk screen, he has featured important people, celebrities from the world of politics as well as cinema. Mao Zedong, the leader, is featured on the left. There is a self-portrait in the center, while the figure to the right is of the celebrated film personality and icon in her lifetime, Marilyn Monroe. Featured here are two portraits. The one to the left is by the American painter Grant Wood. The one to the right is a self-portrait painted by Frida Kahlo, the Mexican painter. Grant Wood, in this portrait, which is also known as the American Gothic, shows an elderly couple standing in front of their house. Americans, particularly in rural America, were extremely possessive about their homes. Grant Wood's style shows a lot of realism with careful attention to detail. Mexican painter Frida Kahlo's work, the self-portrait, shows a very different kind of approach to the self-portrait, where she is seen surrounded by various elements. Kahlo's personal life was fraught with tragedies, and the anguish, the trauma, the loneliness which she went through in her life is reflected in this self-portrait. Frida Kahlo can be seen here facing the viewer, wearing a necklace of thorns, and other elements add an interest to the work. There is a hummingbird, there is a black cat, and also a monkey, which is observed here. Other genres of painting include photorealism and hyperrealism. Photorealism was a phenomenon of the 1970s and can be seen here in the works of Chuck Close, the American artist. Photorealist artists worked closely following a photograph, and their works were extremely realistic. Hyperrealism was an advancement of photorealism, and here in both painting and sculpture, one can see the artist almost working and following a high resolution photograph. Other materials such as polyester, fiber, resin, etc. was also used in sculpture here.